There's a lot of noise in our graph since we are plotting the mean of y for every possible tenure or x value. Recall from lesson 4 that we can adjust this noise by binning our x-axis differently. Let me show you one of those changes in the bin width. Here's our code from before, and instead of using tenure here, I'm going to replace this with a different version or a formula so that way I can bin some of the tenures together. Now, let's see the difference when I plot this graph. Notice how I have slightly less noise in my plot. We still see some of the same peaks from before, especially here, but it's much smoother in general. Here's another one using the number 30 instead of the number 7. And here's a graph with very high bias but much less variance using the number 90. Here I plotted all the graphs so that way we could compare it to the original one. Notice that as the bin size increases, we see less noise on the plot. Our estimates for the mean are adjusted since we have more data points for our new values of tenure. In lesson 4, we introduced smoothers as one tool for an analyst to use in these types of situations. So instead of using geom line here, I'd like you to use geom smooth to add a smoother to this plot. Try doing this in this next programming assignment.